the pylon, GCB conveyances to the pylon. You want to modify that, but you can. I can do that. In principle, I can make a gauge, unless magnetic gauge invariant, interpolating operator from Paris, but I'll have photons from there. It will not affect the matter normalization. Right. And. I can do that, because everything that says here, I can include that the only thing that's missing is photons from that pion. There's no missing perturbation here, you know, in a particular gauge.
So the difference
in
calculations
is about a pattern,
right?
So there's different calculations into here.
But you should have some
residual dependence on the regulator,
because you're not calculating.
The regulator, because I'm dropping the zero node, because when momentum goes to zero, I did a cancellation. What is the regulator is essentially the pion, right? It's the next node up goes like one over L.
Just this one, but of course here you would expect all nodes to contribute, so it's not really, it's just a
And so this is good. When I arrived here, not every time ordering made sense, but we've now fixed that. So every time ordering now looks as though it makes sense.
Can I just ask about that? In fact, so this is after the photon being emitted,
yes.
Before it sends up anyway. The pioneer really, I mean, each pioneer flash, that could be 3 pounds.
So this you shouldn't take seriously at all. It's, you get what you better choose to do this.
You can have a light engine in the front.
You could, and then the photon node is of order 1 over A. Right. So you could have that. You have that, right? Okay. But the dominant behaviour, the behaviour we have is, so here's the pion created, here it's annihilated at that late Hamiltonian, right? If you've got an energetic state, then that's going to be suppressed exponentially. So everything occurs around here in the ship. Again, this is to show that I stole this rather than writing all this out. Again, from Gordon Martinelli's slide last week in Brunesco, this is to show that we're also doing the gamma zero point. You've got a slightly different notation, so I've been calling the photon into a K. This is gamma zero point like, just from this diagram. And this is where I'd welcome any insights that the experts have in the audience. At the moment, what we've done here in this calculation is to evaluate the graph, taking the time, this is taking the time to be infinite, so we can do the Q0 integration, the K0 or Q0 integration, and we're then left with a sum over the 3 million intermediates of the photon. Now, the intuition we have from the work that's been done up to now is that you will want to drop the zero node here and evaluate that. But if there are any other suggestions, then that'd be good, right? It's just how to deal now with the finite volume effects. I don't know if this is clear what's done here. So you take this diagram and you integrate over the energy of the photon, and Q then is the Q momentum.
You want to code up this expression and subtract it from the calculation we get from
the diagram. Exactly, exactly. Now, clearly the zero mode and the real zero mode, where all four components are zero, are identical clearly. But, and the intuition we've learned about making sure we preserve single moment. The transition, what do I want to call it? Yeah, I will want to drop, I mean, I think what we're learning is that we want to drop all the spatial zero nodes for all time, for Q0s, Q4s.
Because
there
have to be
extended
any descriptions with the zero nodes to the regular just the whole thing.